Welcome. My name's Shelley Trotter. I'm the kids pastor at Howe, Simply God, and I'm just excited about our kids crusade coming up. And I just want to, over the years, it's just exciting. The kids have fun. There's songs. There's puppets. And most importantly, they learn about the Word of God. The Tills do a great job with that. And the most important thing of the kids crusade is that they have a relationship with Jesus, that they have him in their hearts. And then they can be a witness to the families, and may the families come in. If you've never been, just bring your kids. They're going to have fun. Like I said, there's songs, there's puppets, and the kids have fun. And then the Tills do a great job with bringing the Word of God, and they just enjoy it. And that most importantly is that they'll have a relationship with Jesus, and they will draw closer to him. And then hopefully through that they can draw other friends and families to come to know Jesus. So I hope to see you there.
I've been to Kids Crusade many times, and my favorite thing about it is praise and worship. You're going to have a blast. There's going to be many people there that are going to be really excited to meet you. If you've never been before, this is your year.
Church, can we all stand together across the sanctuary? And I would like to invite as many as would like to come up to the front. Let's begin the service with praise and worship and prayer. And let's let the Lord know that he is truly welcome in this place today. Lord, we thank you today for your love, for your grace and your mercy, Lord. This is the day that you have made. And Lord, we're going to rejoice and be glad. For Lord, you said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. So Lord, today we want to lift up the name of Jesus, the name that's above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee would bow, every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Lord, we welcome you into this place today. Lord, through every part of the service, Lord, through our worship, through our singing, through the preaching of your word, Lord, that it all be done to bring glory and honor to your precious holy name. Have your way today, we pray and ask in Jesus' name. Fill every heart and soul one more time with your anointing and power. We pray your healing touch upon this community. We pray your healing touch upon our nation, upon our leaders, Father. We pray, God, that you would have your way across this land, Lord. Revive our hungry hearts one more time. For you said, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, that we would hear from from heaven, that you would forgive our sin, that you would heal our land. Lord, we need a resurrection power in this world today, in our church and in our lives, Lord. Touch us, we pray tonight, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Can you give the Lord a hand clap and a shout of praise? He is worthy, and we bless his name. Did you come to lift up the name of Jesus? Let's have church today. called us by name, and because he has called us, he knows who we are. He knows us by name, and we can truly say, I thank God for all that he has done. Let's put our hands together. Let's worship the Lord.
Wandering in the night, wanting a place to hide this weary soul, this bag of bones. I try with all my might, but I just can't win the fight. I'm slowly drifting, a vagabond. Just when I ran out of road, I met a man I didn't know, and he told me that I was not alone. Oh, he picked me up, he turned me around, he placed my feet on solid ground. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, because he healed my heart.
Free.
clap and a shout of praise.
Amen. Page 286.
I'm in the way, the bright and shining way. I'm in the glory land way. Telling the world that Jesus saved today. Yes, I'm in.
Says, I don't care what they tell you on the news. I don't care what takes place. There's one way and one way only. Page 66. Praise God.
There are many paths through this world of sin, but there's only one I shall travel in. It's the old cross road, or the way called straight. There's just one way to the pearly gate. There's just one way to the pearly gate, to the crown of life and the friends who wait. It's the old cross road, or the way called straight. There's just one way. Some who sneer at the old crossroad, at the pearly gate, and the souls of bone. Yet I mind them not, but with happy song of assurance sweet, still I press along. There's just one way. The friends who wait is the old crossroad, or the way called straight. There's just one way to the pearly gate. Others risk their souls on some new-made way, thinking they will come to the gate someday. Oh, but they'll find out ere their lives are done. One way to the
I'm not one for saying that I could do anything, 'cause I'm nothing, nothing but no one. I'm one more grain of sand, except I've been touched by the Master's strong hand. Oh, I feel the touch of the Master's strong hand. He's leading me on through this wearisome land. My footsteps searched for every answer, and you can't comprehend. If those old everyday burdens, they seem to fall without end. When in life's room full of empty, you helpless stand. Just wait for the touch of my Master's strong hand. Oh, I'll feel the touch of the Master's strong hand. He's leading along. If you've searched for every answer, yet you can't comprehend. If those everyday burdens, they seem to fall without end. When in life's room full of empty, stand. Just wait for the touch of my Master's strong hand. Do you feel it this morning? Sing it. Oh, I feel the touch of the Master's strong hand. Thank you, Jesus. He's leading footsteps, they would falter too wide the gulf to span, except for the touch of the Master.
I want to encourage you this morning, if you've got a need in your life or just need the touch of the Master's strong hand, to come forward right now. Just come on, don't miss out on what God wants to do.
Yes, come on.
Come on. Anybody, come ahead.
Hallelujah.
Lord, we come to you this morning. We know there's needs among us, Lord, that only you can, the touch of your hand. make the difference. Lord, we just put our faith and trust in you. We reach out to you. We hold all these needs up to you. We ask you, Lord, that you would build our faith through our trials, through the things that go on in our life, Lord. And we ask as we go through the rest of this service, Lord, that we would not be held back on pride and inhibitions, Lord, but that we would reach out to you the way you ask us to, that we would honor and glorify you in every way in our worship and our praise, and Lord, that as we study your word, that you'll lift us up, that you'll, that we can fill into other people's lives, and we're careful to give you honor, glory, and praise for all that. In Jesus' name.
Seated if you can, continue to worship the Lord with this choir as they minister in song right now.
This nation was founded on God. It was founded for people wanting to come and worship God in their own way. And that has not changed since the Mayflower hit Plymouth Rock in the 1600s. We are a godly nation. We are a nation founded upon the salvation of Jesus Christ with the power of the Holy Ghost. We are Americans, but we are most importantly children of God. And yes, He is our protector. And you can, I don't know how you can say it. God's hand was on that man yesterday. There's no other way it could have been. No other way. God's hand was upon him. And so we know that God has His hand. Even in the political processes, God had His hand. But all Satan wants to do is tear us apart. He wants to tear this nation apart because this is the last bastion of religious freedom in this world. And if he can tear this nation apart, he's got the world wrapped up. But you know what? Jesus has not come back yet. That trumpet has not sounded yet. That trumpet is getting ready to sound soon, sooner than we think. But it has not sounded yet. So we still have the almighty, all wonderful, all power, grace of God still upon us today. And for every step that we take, we're one step closer to glory. One step, one more step. We're closer to heaven now than we were. Every step, every breath that you take, you're one breath closer to walking through heaven's gates. But what are we going to do with that? He's holy. He's our protector. He's our provider. He's our deliverer. He's our healer. But we have a mission to do. Brother Daniel can't do it all on his own. We support this pastor with everything, with every fiber of our being, or at least I do, because I've known him most of his life. But we have to be the laborers that go into the harvest field. It's our responsibility. Because you know people that I don't. I know people that you don't. Shadoa, James, everyone knows people that we don't know each other. But we are sometimes the only light that they will ever see. When we walk outside this church door, what Jesus are they going to see? Are they going to see the Jesus that was done unto the least of these, my brethren? Or are they going to see an arrogant, self-righteous, condescending person saying, oh, well, I go to church. We are all broken. We are all sinners. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But being justified freely by His grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. And so He's holy. He's holy. He's holy. He's holy. He's holy.
Sanctuary. I'm going to ask you a question, church. Has God been awesome in your life? Has He been holy in your life? Has He been mighty in your life? Has He been a healer in your time of sickness? Has He been a provider for you in your time of need? Has He been a shelter for you in your time of storm? Well, has He? If He has, what's our response to Him? What is our response to Him? Does anybody have a response to everything that God has done for you? Does anybody have an awesome praise to offer unto the Lord? Does anybody have a holy praise to offer unto the Lord? Does anybody have a powerful praise to offer unto the Lord? I believe we ought to lift up our hands today and give the Lord our best praise. Give the Lord our highest praise. He is worthy of all the praise. He is worthy of all the glory. He is worthy of all the honor. For You are holy.
Holy, holy, holy. He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's awesome. Awesome. And He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
Provider,
provider,
provider.
the Lord a hand clap and a shout of praise. He is worthy. We bless his name. We bless his name. You can just lift your hands if you want to. Just spend some time worshiping him, loving on Jesus. That's why we're here today, is to love on Jesus, to wait in his presence, to seek his will, to seek his kingdom, to seek his face, encounter the living Savior. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. His word says, they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. When you wait on the Lord, he's going to bring healing in your time of sickness. He's going to bring deliverance in your time of captivity. He's going to bring a shelter to you in your time of storm. He's going to be your rock in a weary land. He's going to be your way maker when you don't know which way to turn. For he said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. He's going to be your awesome God. He's the rewarder of them that diligently seek his face. Is there anybody here today that came to seek the face of God? Is there anybody here today that's hungry for revival in your heart and soul? You're hungry for revival in your family. You're hungry for revival in your church. You're hungry for revival in your life. Revival comes when we wait in his presence. Revival comes when we wait in his presence. I don't know about you, but I'm still basking in what took place in this service last Sunday morning and Sunday night and Wednesday night. The river of God is moving, but you must not let that river be stopped. Don't let that river be stopped. Don't let that river be hindered by anything that you have put into it. If you need something from God, the Spirit of God is moving in this place right now. All you've got to do is ask and ye shall receive. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and the door shall be opened unto you. If you had something going on in your life that you needed a desperate touch from God, I wouldn't wait another minute before coming to this altar. But this altar is open for you right now. This altar is open for you right now. We thank you, Jesus. There is a river that flows from deep within. There is a river. Brother Coy, if you can sing that. Let that river of God flow in your life this morning.
There is a river.
We can take some time this morning and let that river flow.
That flows from deep.
Thank you, Jesus. For that fountain? Are you thirsty for that living water?
That free.
Are you thirsty for that stream of life to flow in your soul today?
Frees the soul from sin.
every head bowed, every eye closed. I cannot move any further in this service this morning. You may have been in church all of your life. I'm speaking to somebody today. I believe this is a word from the Lord to somebody in this place today. You've been raised in church. You know the truth of God's word. There was once a time in your life you hungered and thirsted after the blessings of God. You hungered and thirsted after the holiness of God. But you have drifted, and your life is on sinking sand. And you've got to get yourself turned around with God. You've got to get yourself planted on the solid rock. You've got to get yourself planted on Jesus Christ. While there is still time, the river of God is flowing. The river of God is moving. And I'm here today to tell you, this could be someone's last opportunity to encounter Jesus in a way like you need to encounter Him. And I believe that God has a message for Howe Assembly of God. God is saying, if you will hunger after me, if you will thirst after me, I will pour out my spirit upon you. I will anoint you. I will equip you. I will empower you to minister to your family, to minister to your co-workers, to minister to people in this community who do not know Jesus. If you want to be effective in your witness for Christ, you want to be effective to minister to people who desperately need Jesus, you need to be in these altars. You need to be in these altars. In fact, I believe it would be great if every one of us could just come and find a place around these altars and say, God, I need more of your power. I need more of your spirit. I need your anointing. I cannot make it from one day to the next without that anointing, without that power. But if you will humble yourselves before God, He's going to lift you up. He's going to empower you. He's going to equip you. He's going to give you the courage to stand for God. He's going to give you the courage to stand for truth. He's going to give you the courage to do the work that God has called you to do. So let's step into that river today. Let that river flow in your life. Let that river flood into your hungry, thirsty soul. And allow that river to overflow into people's lives around you, to overflow into your family, to overflow in your homes, to overflow in your community. Lord, that's our prayer here this morning. God, that your river would flow into our life. Your power, your mercy, your strength. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
And there came a sound from heaven, like a rushing mighty wind. It filled their hearts with singing, and it gave them peace within. Is a
Praise God.
lift your hands and praise Him, for He is worthy of all the praise. He is worthy of all the glory. He's worthy of all the honor. We thank You, Jesus. We worship Your name, Jesus, for You alone are worthy of all the praise, worthy of all the glory, worthy of all the honor. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We thank You, Jesus. We thank You, Jesus. When the Spirit of God moves in an atmosphere of worship like this, there is nothing impossible with God. Absolutely nothing impossible with God. He said in His word, blessed are they who do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled.
Amen.
They shall be filled. If you missed last Sunday night, I encourage you, please go on YouTube and watch last Sunday night service. It's on Facebook. We've even got it narrowed down to just the message. A message on the river of revival. A service like what we had last Sunday and Sunday night and then Wednesday night and then tonight. These are not planned services. This is what happens when we follow the leading of the Holy Spirit. You know, I've got a message series that we've been on talking about how we know that we're born again. We don't have to wonder if we're saved. We can know that we're saved. We have the evidence of salvation through knowing that our life has been changed and knowing that our sins have been forgiven. And we can have the assurance to know that our name is written in heaven. We can know that we're saved.
Amen.
The message I was going to preach this morning, we can preach next Sunday morning. It's going to talk about sanctification. If you want to know how to be sanctified, if you want to know how to live a holy life, services like this, an atmosphere of worship like this, this is what we call drawing near to God, drawing near to Him, allowing His river to flow into our life, to wash away anything that shouldn't be there, to flood into our life His blessing, to flood into our life His power, to flood into our life His anointing. Several things going on here at Howe Assembly. Be in prayer with us. Our Kids Crusade's coming up. 2 weeks from tomorrow it begins our Kids Crusade. And the Teal family will be here 2 weeks from today preaching Sunday morning and Sunday night. And we're believing God for just a revival in our children's ministry. But not only revival in children's ministry, but I believe it can be revival that affects this entire community. And let me tell you something, church. I am believing for the impossible to be possible. I'm praying for the unseen miracle to be seen. And I want you to pray and fast with me over these next 2 weeks. Some of you may receive some mail in the church, mail in your mailbox from the church advertising this Kids Crusade. Take those postcards and give to people that need it. Please do not throw those away. But we are sending out 500 postcards around this county to families that have children. And we are praying that as they receive this flyer from our church in the mail, instead of going door to door, knocking on doors, we're using the post office to do this. And we're going to pray over these postcards and believe God that God's going to use this to minister to people. If there was ever a time that we need to see revival, it's today, and we're seeing revival here at Howe Assembly. Don't take for granted opportunities of worship such as what we have here this morning. And every time that we come together, Sunday nights at 5:30, is the key to everything that's happening here at Howe Assembly. If you've never been to our 5:30 prayer service, I dare you to come to it. It will change your life. It will change your life. And Sunday nights has been changing how we do church. I preach better on Sunday nights than I do on Sunday morning because we have the prayer service. The message I preached last Sunday, I didn't even have notes for it. God spoke to me during the prayer service and He told me the scripture, told me the title. I wrote down the title and I wrote down the scripture. I can't even tell you what scripture was. I don't have my note card with me, but I needed that one line. But God used that message to speak into our hearts. And I believe God's going to continue to flood that river through this church, through this community, to change this community with the gospel message of Jesus Christ. Do you believe that today? Can we all stand together and can we give the Lord a big hand clap and a shout of praise for all He has done? God is doing something great here at Howe Assembly, and I'm excited that we get to be part of it and allow God to continue to strengthen us. Don't forget, tonight after the evening service, we're having a special celebration in the fellowship hall for Sister Alyssa's birthday, and a cake, ice cream. Several of you are bringing appetizers and salads and all of that good stuff. So come here early tonight. We'll have the doors open. Prayer service at 5:30. Service at 6. God bless you. We'll see you this evening.
I offer up to you. Spirit out as I